हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट थ्योरम, दैट इज इक्वल कॉर्ड ऑफ अ सर्कल आर इक्विडिस्टेंट फ्रॉम द सेंटर। सो बिफोर दिस वी हैव कवर्ड वन थ्योरम दैट अ कॉर्ड ड्रॉन परपेंडिकुलर फ्रॉम द कॉर्ड बाइसेक्ट द कॉर्ड। सो इन दिस वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट इक्वल कॉर्ड ऑफ अ सर्कल आर इक्विडिस्टेंट फ्रॉम द सेंटर। सो इन दिस डायग्राम वी हैव गिवन अ सर्कल विथ सेंटर ओ and AB and CD are equal chord. So a circle with center O in which AB and CD are two equal chord. And here we have drawn OM and ON. These are perpendicular distance from the chord from the center. So OM is the perpendicular distance of chord AB and ON is the perpendicular distance of chord CD. So here we have to prove that OM equal to ON. That means this perpendicular distance will be equal. So in proof, we can take triangle BMO and DNO. So taking triangle BMO and DNO, here we can join OB and OD. So by taking triangle BMO and DNO, so here first of all angle BMO will be equal to angle DNO because they are 90 degree. As we know, OM and ON are perpendicular from AB and CD, therefore angle BMO and DNO are 90 degree. After this, it will be OB equal to OD. OB equal to OD as it is the radii of same circle. That's why OB will be equal to OD. Now we can also say that here BM equals to DN. So here BM equals to DN. Why they are equal? Because we have AB equals to CD, and if AB equals to CD, then half of AB, so half of AB will be BM and half of CD will be DN. Why? Because as we know, perpendicular from chord bisect the chord. So OM is perpendicular, so OM will bisect the chord. Therefore we can say that here AB will be divided into two part. So here it will be MB. That means MB will be equal to half of AB. Similarly, here also ND. ND it will be equal to half of CD. That's why we can say that here BM equals to DN as half of AB equals to half of CD. Therefore, we can say that triangle BMO is congruent to triangle DNO by RHS. That is right angled hypotenuse side. So by RHS these two triangles are congruent, and if these triangles are congruent, then we can say that OM equals to ON by CPCT, that is corresponding part of congruent triangle. So here we can say that equal chord of circle are equidistant from the center. Now after this, there is one more theorem, 10.7. In that theorem, the theorem 10.7 is converse of this theorem 10.6. In that theorem, if the equidistant from the center are equal, then chords are also equal. So in that case, we have to prove that chord AB equals to chord DC. So it can also be done like the same way. So in that case, we have given OM will be equals to ON, and we have to prove AB equals to CD. So that theorem you can do yourself. That theorem is also same as this theorem. Now after this, we are going to start next exercise, that is 10.4. So next question of exercise 10.4. So in exercise 10.4, in question number 1, two circles of radii 5 cm and 3 cm intersect at two points, and the distance between their center is 4 cm. Find the length of common chord. So when we draw this diagram, suppose we have a diagram that is in this one circle having radius 5 cm. So here we have radius of larger circle is 5 cm. So we can take OP equals to 5 cm, and radius of smaller circle that is equals to 3 cm. So here we can take O dash P, it will be equals to 3 cm, and here when we join this OA, OA will be equal to 5 centimeter, and we have also given that the distance between the centers of the circle is equal to 4 centimeter. So O and O dash are the center of the circle. So O dash equal to 4 centimeter. Now in triangle AOO dash, so in this triangle, using Pythagoras theorem. Why we are using Pythagoras theorem? Because as we know, a perpendicular or the distance from the chord will always perpendicular. So AB is a chord. So in this chord, this OO dash will form a perpendicular distance. Therefore, by using Pythagoras theorem, we can say that here OA square equal to OO dash square plus O dash A square. Here value of OA square, OA is 5, so 5 square equals to OO dash is 4, so 4 square plus O dash A square, so it will be 25. This 4 into 4, 16 will come this side and it will be subtracted and equal to O dash A square. So here O dash A will be equal to this 25 minus 16 will be 9 and it will become under root 9. So O dash A will equal to 3. Now here we have to find length of AB. So as we know, AB equals to twice of O dash A. So value of O dash A is 3, so AB equals to 2 into 3. So we can say that AB equal to 6 centimeter, or length of common chord is 6 centimeter. So here 6 centimeter will be answer. Now after this, see next question. So after this, in question number second, if two equal chord of circle intersect within the circle, then prove that the segment of one chord are equal to the corresponding segment of other chord. So here, according to this question, if two equal chords are intersect in a circle, so suppose here AB and CD are two equal chord and they are intersecting at point E, then here we have to prove that the corresponding segments of these chords are equal. So corresponding segments means here this segment will be equal to this segment. So here we have to prove that this EC will be equal to EB. If we can prove that this EB and EC are equal, then these segment, that is segment AB and segment CD, will also equal. So here, given a circle with center O, we have the center O and in which chord AB and CD are equal, and here we have given chord AB and CD are equal. We have to prove here segment of chords are equal. So here we have to prove that in this EB equal to CE. Now in proof, so we have first of all OM perpendicular to AB and ON perpendicular to CD, means they are making 90 degree angles, and also AB equal to CD. And if AB equal to CD, then here we can say that AM equals to ND. So here AM will be equal to ND. These parts are equal, and MB equal to CN, and MB will be equal to CN. These parts are also equal. Now taking triangle OME and ONE. So here we can take these two triangle OME and ONE. So in these two triangles, first of all, angle OME, OME will equal to angle ONE, as given, or we can say that each 90 degree, they are also 90 degree because they are perpendicular. Now after this, OE equal to OE. So OE is common, and OM equals to ON. OM equals to ON, as in the previous theorem we have studied that a distance from equal chords is equal. So perpendicular distance from equal chord. So distance from the equal chord, here we can write. Therefore, triangle OME is congruent to triangle ONE by RHS, that is right angled hypotenuse side. So if triangles are congruent, then by CPCT we can say that ME equal to EN by CPCT. Now after this, we can say that AM plus ME, here AM plus ME will be equal to ND plus EN, ND plus EN. So here ME and NE, ME and NE are equal. Therefore here, by adding this AM plus ME, AM plus NE, so it will become AE, and here ND plus NE, it will become DE or ED. So we can say that equals to ed. Now after this we know that ab equal to cd, chords are equal, so on place of ab we can write ae plus eb and on place of cd we can write ed plus ce. So here we can say that if this ae and ed are equal, ae and ed are equal, therefore eb and ce will also equal. So if eb equals to ce, then we can say that the segment of chords are equal. So here these segments of chords are also equal. Now after this, see next question. Now after this, see question number 4. In question number 4, if a line intersect two concentric circle with center O at A, B, C and D, then we have to prove that AB equal to CD. So in diagram we have given two concentric circles. So what are concentric circle? The circle which have a common center. So we have given two circles and center is O. So here in this given two concentric circle with center O, A, B, C and D are points on the circle. So here we have given A, B, C and D are the points on the circle. Now in this we have to prove AB equal to CD. Now here we will do one construction. First of all, draw OM perpendicular to AD. So we have drawn this OM perpendicular to AD and join OA, OD, OB and OC, and this we can join. So OA, OD, OB and OC, it will be joined. Now in proof, first of all, taking triangle AOM and triangle DOM. So in these two triangles AOM and here DOM, in these two triangles, first of all, angle OMA equals to angle OMD, each 90 degree, they are 90 degree, and OA equals to OD. So here OA equals to OD, they are radii of same circle, and in this OM equals to OM, it will be common, therefore we can say triangle AOM congruent to triangle DOM by right angle hypotenuse side or RHS. So we can say that AM equals to DM by CPCT. It will be equation 1. Now similarly in this small triangle, that is OMB and OMC. So in these two triangles we can say that BOM is congruent to triangle COM by RHS. Here BOM and COM will also congruent, and by CPCT we can say that here BM will be equal to CM, and this will be equation number 2. Now we can subtract equation number 2 from 1. So equation 1 minus equation 2, it will be AM minus BM equal to DM minus CM. So when AM minus BM, so here AM minus BM will be equal to AB, and DM minus CM, DM minus CM will be equal to CD. So it will be AB equal to CD. So we have to prove AB equals to CD. So this will be the answer. Now after this, see next question. So after this, see question number 6. In question number 6, a circular park of radius 20 meter is situated in a colony. Three boys, Ankur, Sayed and David, are sitting at equal distance on its boundary, each having a toy telephone in his hand to talk each other. Find the length of string of each phone. So in this question we have given, suppose a circular park, and in this circular park these three boys are sitting. So here Ankur, here Sayed and here David, we can take their name as A, S and D, and they are sitting at equal distance, that means A S equals to S D equals to D A. So here in triangle A S D we can say that A S equals to S D equals to D A, and equals to A we can take it as A. And we are also given that the radius of this park is 20 meters. So here OA is radius, so OA equals to 20 meters. Now if we take it SM, first of all we can draw SM perpendicular to HD. So we can say that SM is perpendicular to SD. So here this SM will be equals to half of A. Now in triangle ASM, by using Pythagoras theorem, it will be AS square equals to SM square plus AM square. So value of AS is A, so it will be A square equals to value of SM is half A, so half A square plus ए एम स्क्वायर. नाउ बाय सॉल्विंग इट इट विल बी ए स्क्वायर एंड 1/2 ए होल स्क्वायर विल बिकम 1/4 ए स्क्वायर. सो दिस विल कम दिस साइड. सो 1/4 ए स्क्वायर विल बी माइनस एंड इक्वल टू ए एम स्क्वायर. सो हेयर ए एम स्क्वायर विल बी इक्वल टू बाय सॉल्विंग दिस बाय टेकिंग एल सी एम इट विल बी 4 ए स्क्वायर माइनस ए स्क्वायर. सो इट विल बिकम 3/4 ए स्क्वायर. नाउ वी कैन से दैट ए एम विल बी इक्वल टू अंडर रूट 3/4 ए स्क्वायर. सो बाय सॉल्विंग इट विल बी ए एम इक्वल टू अंडर रूट 3/2 ए. नाउ वी हैव ओ ए विल बी इक्वल टू 2/3 ऑफ ए एम. सो इन दिस इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल वैन ड्रॉन इन अ सर्कल सो हेयर द रेशियो ऑफ दिस रेडियस विद दिस परपेंडिकुलर इट विल बिकम ओ ए विल बी 2/3 ऑफ ए एम. सो हेयर दिस ओ ए विल बी 2/3 ऑफ ए एम. सो वैल्यू ऑफ ओ ए इज 20. सो हेयर 2/3 इन टू एंड वैल्यू ऑफ ए एम इज अंडर रूट 3/2 a. From there we can write its value. Now 2 will be cancelled. Now for finding value of a, a will be equal to 20 into 3 upon under root 3. This can be cross multiply. So root 3 will cancel by 3, root 3 time. So here value of a will be 20 root 3. So here we can say that the length of a string of each phone will be 20 root 3 meter. So this will be the answer. So in this way you can do the remaining questions of this exercise. Now you can take your homework. So you have to complete this exercise. So you can do exercise 10.4. And after this we will start next exercise, that is 10.5. So thank you for watching the video.